guys, it's Kate. Welcome to Coparenting with Narcissist 101. Please subscribe if you haven't. And guys, today I want to ask what the narcissist thinks of you after the discard abandonment. What does the narcissist think of you after they ran off or you left? First of all, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what they think of you. That is none of your problem. But just in case this answer is needed to, you know, save mankind. there are two things actually. One is that they're having a difficult time processing your independence. They think that you're too independent. And because you know that when they are with you, almost I'm sure everybody felt this, they believe that without them, nothing is going to move. Nothing. It doesn't matter how small it is. It doesn't matter how relevant it is. It doesn't matter. They believe that they have to be part of it for anything to move on, because they look at you as an idiot. You don't know what the hell you're doing. So it means that they need to be there to do everything because they are the one that know everything. You know. So when the relationship ends and you are busy doing all these things that they have already told themselves that you can do, they have difficulty processing that. You know, they have the constant processing that you're independent, that you're actually going out there and taking care of things that they've already told everybody in your street that you can't do, or everybody at work that you cannot do, you know, so that you will need help to do that. You know, you don't know, because like I said, they have a narrative of you that is convenient for them. They've told themselves a story about you that is convenient for them, because this is what they need to tell themselves to be able to do what they need to do to you. They need to be able to classify you as an idiot. You don't know what you're doing. You're not that smart. You're not that great. You think you know that. You don't know. You're ignorant. You know, they need to be able to tell themselves all that instead of spending the time to actually, well, they can't do that because that's what they envy you for. They can't admire these qualities that you have. So they're busy trying to rewrite your story for themselves, you know. So if you're bright, you're a smart person, now in their world, you're stupid, you know, you can't do anything right, you know. So this is what they tell themselves when you leave the relationship and you are being you, because you have always been you. You have always been smart, you have always been intelligent, you definitely know what the hell you're doing, you're not ignorant. So when you are being you after the relationship, they have issue with this. They have difficulty processing your independent. They think you're independent because you are supposed to need them to function. And that is not happening. Now, another thing is fear. Now, I know that sounds weird. They are scared of you, guys. They are scared of you. And it sounds strange considering that, you know, they're out there projecting all their weaknesses on you. But they're scared of you. They're scared that they don't know where to place you anymore. Especially if you have succeeded in responding and not react. You know, like you're picking and choosing what you respond to. You know, which is a completely, 180 from what you're doing while you're with them. Because you didn't know what you're doing with. So you're addressing everything that they throw at you. So, but now that if you reach that point where you are responding, you know, not reacting, especially then if it doesn't involve the children, you don't even give a shit, really. You know, so they cannot place you anymore. So they are scared of what you are going to do next. That's where the fear is. They don't know. They don't have control now, because, you know, they need to be in control of everything in the environment. That's why they need to, they come into an environment, it doesn't sit well with them. They have to throw something out there so that they'll match what is, you know, within them, that they are familiar with. So that way they are now in control. They are not out of control anymore. So that's why when they come to a place where there's peace, there's quiet, there's joy, there's laughter, they'll find something to do, throw it out there so that they'll match the chaos within themselves, because that is what they understand. That is what they are comfortable in. That's now they're able to control the room. They've changed the atmosphere of the room and they're good. You know, so with you being out there, they're scared of you because they can't control what you're saying. They can't control your who's talking to you. They can't control your friends. They can't control your actions. They are not in control, period. That's the thing. They are not in control of you. That makes them scared because now I don't know what she's going to do or what he's going to do when I do this or say this, because they used to be able to predict what the hell you're going to do next. Why? Because you didn't know what you're dealing with. But now that you know, and obviously they don't know that you know, so they're surprised when certain things are thrown at you, thrown your way, you don't react, you don't give them the response they want. So now they're scared of what it is you're doing. They don't know. They do not know, you know. So that's where the fear of you comes in, is that I don't know what direction they're coming from. I can't predict what direction they're coming from. I used to be able to predict what direction they're coming from, but now I don't know. Of course, they're not going to tell you that they're scared of you or even try to show it, but best believe that they're scared of what you're going to do next. So they don't, because they can't say what it is, that how you react to anything, which they're so good at doing before, because you don't know what you don't know about them. But now you know about them. They don't know you know about them, of course. So that's their fear. And then the first one was that they're having a little difficulty with your independence, because this is not the narrative. This is not what they told themselves about you. You know, so that is how the narcissist is thinking after the discard or abandonment. That's exactly what they think of you. You're too independent and they're scared of you. You know, I know it sounds weird. It might not look like that's what's going on, but best believe, they are masters, obviously, are projecting rubbish on you, but they cannot control what you're doing. They cannot control what you're saying. They cannot control who you're relating with. That is, they're scared of that. It makes it, definitely, they don't want to be in that kind of environment. They don't know what you're going to do next. That is the fear. They don't know. Control that. And then the independence which is you being you, because you've always been independent, but because they've told themselves the story while they're with you, you know, you living your life the way you're living now, which is probably what is in you, that has always been you, is them looking at you like you're too independent, because that wasn't the narrative, you know. So guys, yes, as crazy as it sounds, but it doesn't matter what they think of you, obviously, once you're done with these people, it shouldn't be an issue what they think of you. It shouldn't bother you what they think of you. You know, but like I said, if this is an answer that is needed for something very crucial, this is what it is. All right, guys, get your mind together. Everything else will fall into place. Take care.